In this AUTOSOL training session, I will be walking you through the object tree in the configuration section of ACM. For this demonstration, I will be using a computer with a Windows 7 operating system. The object tree in ACM is used to display and organize all of the objects within your ACM configuration. If you click on the drop-down menu in the object tree, you can select a view type to control the way your objects are displayed. The built-in ways to view the objects in your configuration are by object type, category, primary connection, or secondary connection. There is also a folder view option, which allows you to completely customize the layout of your objects. To see an example of our suggested folder architecture, you can create your devices using the Station Wizard. For more details, check out the Station Wizard and Folder Structure video. Next to the View Type selection is the Options drop-down menu where you can refresh the tree, collapse all nodes, and expand all nodes. In a new installation of ACM, the default view type is Folder View, and the only objects in the tree are the $ system, $ perf, and $ server. The $ system object is a folder that houses all of your objects when using the folder view. The $ perf object has no configurable parameters. It is used as the owner of OPC items that provide Windows performance monitor data. The $ server object contains properties which allow you to control how the server operates. Right-clicking on the $ server object gives you the option to edit using Form or Property Grid, Restore Default Properties, Export and Open the Properties. The $ server is where you set up server-level logging, security, aliasing, and other server-level functions. For further information on setting these up, please see the ACM User Guide. Once you have some objects in your configuration, right-clicking on any folder gives you many options to help manage your object tree. The first is Edit using Form or Property Grid. This allows you to view and modify the properties of the object. The next option is Add. Here you can add folders, devices, ports, or other objects to your configuration. You can also choose to copy or create multiple copies. When copying a folder, it will copy all of the child objects within the folder. These copied objects will maintain links to any referenced objects that were outside of the original copied folder. Selecting the Move option allows you to move an object or folder to a different location in your object tree. Objects can also be moved using drag and drop. After Move are the options to rename or delete the selected object. The next option is to enable children and disable children. Selecting these will enable or disable all child objects nested below the selected folder. You can also demand poll children, which will cause a demand poll of every device nested in the selected folder. Next on the list is object count. When selected, a window will open displaying the object count for every object type nested below the selected object. Retrieve history from children will cause ACM to poll all enabled historical data from devices nested in the selected folder. You can also export or import some or all of your configuration. For more information on export and import, check out the ACM Configuration Toolbar training video. You may see some different options when right-clicking on individual objects. These options are based on their object type. When selecting Edit on most objects, you can choose to restore default properties. This is like deleting the object and recreating it from scratch with the same name. You can choose to get references to object. This will open a window showing all of the objects that are referencing the selected one. On device objects where history collection is supported, there is also an option to delete history from device. This does not delete history from inside the device itself, but from the table in the ACM database that is being used to publish the historical data from. The next way to display your objects is called Type View. In this view, every object type is listed in the object tree. If there are any instances of an object type, you can expand the folder for that type to view them. Each are listed with their folder structure information and name. Depending on the type of object, your options when right-clicking them may change. Device objects have the most options. The first option is All Properties Grid View. When selected, this will open a grid view containing every object of that type and every configurable property. If you do not wish to view or edit every property, right-click on the object type and choose the Select Property Grid View. Here you are able to select which properties you will see for that object type in the grid view. The next option is to add object or add multiple objects. When selected, you will be asked to select a folder before ACM will create the object of that type. Other options allow you to enable, disable, demand poll, retrieve history, get an object count, expand or collapse the tree for objects of the type selected. Another option for these objects is export. When right-clicking on the object type and selecting export, it will bring up the export window with all objects of that type selected. Category view breaks out objects into different categories. If you wish to enable all of your connections of every type, right-click the Connections category and select Enable Children. You can do the same for all of your schedules and protocols as well. The Protocols category has a few more options, including Demand Poll Children, Retrieve History from Children, and Object Count. The Primary Connection View and Secondary Connection Views allow you to see the different connections and the devices assigned to them. You can also see the devices without an assigned connection. Within this view, you can enable and disable your connections, enable and disable children, demand poll, retrieve history from children, or get an object count. For more details on setting up the folder view, please watch our Folder Structure and Station Wizard video. Thank you for watching this AUTOSOL training session. If you have any questions, please go to our website, www.autosoln.com, and click on the support link for all support options.